I sense that I need to go back 3 years. Back to the night the pain started. I was still on the force back then. NYPD, Manhattan, Midtown North Precinct, Hell's Kitchen.
So when are you coming to work for me, Detective Payne?
You'd make me work undercover in some hellhole. Sorry, Alex. Michelle and the baby come first. See? My last smoke. Spare for the baby.
That's you, Max. A regular Boy Scout.
See, Alex?
Still out for poker Thursday night, right?
Like taking candy from a baby. Life was good. Sun setting on a sweet summer's day. Smell of freshly mowed lawns. Sounds of children playing. A house across the river on the Jersey side. Beautiful wife and a baby girl. The American dream come true.
Honey, I'm home.
But dreams have a nasty habit of going bad when you're not looking. The sun went down with practice bravado. Twilight crawled across the sky, laden with foreboding. I didn't like the way the show started. They'd give me the best seat in the house, front row center. Something ugly had been tattooed on the wall, a map of things to come. It was a poison syringe, a magic tag full of diabolical meanings.
Listen, someone's broken into my house. Call 911. Yes, someone's broken into my house. They're still here. You have to...
Good. I'm afraid I cannot help you.
Who is this? Hello?
No!
That was 3 years ago. Everything ripped apart in a New York minute. Killer junkies had been high on a previously unknown designer drug, Valkyr, V. After the funeral, I told Alex I'd be transferring to the DEA. It took us 3 long years to get a break in the Valkyr case. Then, finally, 2 months ago, a dime dropper tipped us off that Jack Lupino, a mob boss in the Punchinello crime family, was trafficking. I went undercover, infiltrated the worst mafia family in New York. Monster. I've been slowly working my way from the small time to the big fish, trying to get to the source of the drug. Alex and BB were my only contacts in the DEA, the only ones in this decrepit city who knew I was down here.
BB here. Something urgent has come up with Jack Lupino. You need to meet with Alex immediately at the Roscoe Street station.
I hadn't had a face-to-face with Alex since I'd gone undercover. The feeling hit me like a point-blank shot straight in the face. Something was not right about this. My Beretta stirred nervously under my coat, but the train doors had already shut behind me, and I was in for the ride. Next stop, Roscoe Street Station, and Alex.
Thank you.
emergency door led to an abandoned part of the station, closed off since the early 40s. Something big was going down at Roscoe Street. Maybe that's why Alex had wanted to meet me here. Maybe not. One way or the other, I was gonna find out. Acer Corporation bonds. The Acer success story had recently been on every channel and on the cover of every magazine.
Bye.
Alex had kept me relatively sane for the past 3 years. Now I didn't know how I felt. Somehow he had stumbled upon something big and ended up stepping on Jack Lupino's toes. Lupino ran his racket of sex, drugs, and contract killings from a sleazy hotel in a slum block of tenements. The NYPD was closing in. I could hear the sirens. Their wail was a crescendo. Lupino thought he could get us by taking Alex out and leaving me to take the fall for it. All he had gotten was my attention. Lupino wasn't in his cheap hotel. Instead, I ran into the Finito brothers. My cover had been blown, the door slammed shut behind me, and then I was dodging bullets like raindrops. I'd met Lupino only once. The gangster ran all his rackets through his right-hand man, Vinny Gagniti. Gagniti was a high-strung whiner on the verge of breaking apart, like an over-amped Energizer bunny. He had the brains to run the business, but he lacked the balls, always falling short, taking his frustration out on underage addicts and call girls.
The V deal goes down at your hotel. Jack's exact words, quote, Vinny, you're in charge of this one, unquote. Rico Muerte is coming to see you through. Anything goes wrong and everybody's gonna get dead. Goes double for you. Treat this guy real good. Anything he wants, you give him. Don't screw this up or you're finito, finitos.
A V deal meant added security, locked doors, and lots of nervous thugs with itchy trigger fingers. I'd seen nothing coming in, but that didn't mean it hadn't been there. Rico Muerte was a regular Kaiser Soze, a spook story told to keep the apes in line. 313. The Finitos had scribbled Muerte's room number on the note's margin.
One of our trusted boys has a monkey the size of King Kong on his back. We need your special skills for backup on a major deal.
Collecting evidence had gotten old a few hundred bullets back. I was already so far past the point of no return, I couldn't even remember what it looked like when I had passed it. Big time hustler.
Who the hell?
It's that cop.
Where can I look for his gun? Lupino's tenement buildings were a seedy hangout for all kinds of sleaze. A liquor store, a pawn shop, a laundromat full of mobster bookies and loan sharks. The list went on. The how and why of it was a mystery to me, but they knew I was a cop. They knew I was coming, and they were gonna get real trigger happy about it. I got to see Lupino's hangout all lit up. A bomb went off, turning snow into liquid gold. A pillar of fire lifted the remains of a car straight up into the air. The flames were highlighted on the hood of a black Mercedes-Benz as it coasted down the street real slow, as if the driver didn't have a worry in the world. I got a good look at the man riding shotgun. It was Vladimir, the head of the local Russian mob, the flying Don Punchinello's soup. got meaty. Just the man I've been killing to see.
Payne? Freaking fed! I knew from day one there was something screwy about you. What do you think you're doing? You're a freaking cop. You ain't got squad on us. You can't just come in here waving your piece like it meant something. Yeah! Oh, my God! Oh, God, you shot me! Ah! You're dead, Payne! What the hell are you waiting for, you ape? Kill him! Kill him!
With pleasure, boss.
Got me bailed. I made my cherry on fat. Addressed to Don Punchinello, but Vinny had never had the nerve to finish it.
Jack's gone voodoo. Just the other night, he shot Dino because he wanted to see what his brains looked like splattered on the wall. He's a freaking mad dog. We're running out of men. That business fast.
Gagnetti had been living in mortal fear of his boss. Jack Lupino was a psycho. Vinny Gagnetti was running scared. He could run, but with a bullet in his stomach like a broken bottle of Tabasco, he was quickly running out of time. He knew where his boss was, and I wanted to square things up with Jack Lupino. Gagnetti would be moving fast. I don't know about angels, but it's fear that gives men wings. Lupino.
Screw you!
Bad start, Vinny.
Ah! Police brutality!
I rate pretty high on that.
You can't just hurt me in cold blood?
Just keep telling yourself that. Listen good, Candyman. I'm not gonna be anybody's fall guy. I wanna know where your boss is hiding.
I'll tell you, just don't hurt me no more! Lupino's at Ragnar Rock, the nightclub! Book me! Take me in the home into the freaking jail! Just don't hurt me!
Your rights will be read at your funeral. Ragnarok was as inviting as a headache, flickering and flashing to a machine gun beat. The belly of the nightclub was a gothic theme park that began with bondage games and led to the nasty stuff from there. As subtle with its dark message as a cop killer bullet through the heart. Like father, like son, just like Jack Lupino. I had known there'd have to be a catch in it somewhere, and this one was the Empire State Building of catches. Lupino just pumped up and dying to go 15 rounds with a mutant alligator. And then he started this spooky monkey talk, straight from a bad dream. Mine.
I have tasted the flesh of fallen angels. I've tasted the devil's green blood. It runs in my veins. I've seen beyond the world of skin, the architecture of blood and bow and arrow. Death is coming!
She is coming, and hell follows with her. This is the twilight winter. I am ready to be her son.
Her time is now, and all who stand in her way must die!
Stay that way. He was a bad monster. Turned them into friggin' zombie demons from outer space.
I think he's dead already.
Huh? And that's when it happened.
But dead or not, you've got the wrong guy.
In stepped this knockout femme fatale holding a gun to my face. I returned the favor. Lisa Punchinello. Lisa Punchinello was the Don's wife.
Mona Sachs. Lisa's evil twin.
Your safety's off, evil twin. You might hurt someone with that gun of yours.
Lisa's the damsel in distress. I'm the professional. I'd blow you away without batting an eye.
Sure, and you can check out my credentials splattered all over this joint.
Jack couldn't have framed you, not the state he was in. We're after the same slime bag. Angelo Quincinello's the one who murdered your friend and framed you with it.
You know this for a fact.
I've got my sources.
I don't have a clue these days. I just shoot them as they come. Who put a contract on the Archfiend?
This one's mine. I hate the guts of that sadistic wife-beater. Why not pool our bullets for this one?
I thought you'd never ask. My finger was starting to twitch.
How do you like your whiskey?
I'm easy, as long as you don't try to slip me a Mickey.
You're a real angel, Max.
It was good stuff. Tasted sweet as honey going down.
Nothing personal. Can't risk you going berserk to get away with the kill.
The nightmare was always the same. Violent shapes moving in darkness, old and ugly. The killer's mad laughter was a riddle filled with wicked innuendo. Somewhere, the baby was crying. Captured in a Polaroid moment. I had thought it would last forever, till death do us part. I didn't want to think about it. As long as I didn't, it could never happen. But I had broken my own rule. The thought had already slipped in. Fear was rusty needles poking in my brain. Cold and scaly, it slithered down my chest. Michelle was working part-time in the district attorney's office. Her diary was open on today's entry, her handwriting all pretty curves.
An army dossier found its way to my desk yesterday. Valhalla? Isn't that a Norse myth? Something about Vikings? I tried to tell Max about it, but he was busy, that cute frown on his brow. Guess it's nothing, just a mix-up at the courier service.
From now on, I would always find time for her. It was a hollow promise. Too little, too late. Up in a bad dream. My head felt two sizes too small for my brain.
Max Payne, I envy your name.
And the killer was smiling.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Frankie the Bat Niagara.
Niagara, as in you cry a lot? He had a baseball bat and I was tied to a chair. Pissing him off was the smart thing to do.
Nothing wrong with a little laugh now and then. Take me, for example. I love to watch cartoons. Cartoon violence is a fascinating thing. Let's take a break. I need to take a leak and maybe grab a cold one at the bar. Don't worry. I'll be back to finish this off. And then, it's checkout time.
You play, you pay, you bastard. He swaggered out, and the door clanged shut behind him, locks clicking into place. Everyone makes mistakes. Mine hadn't been to crack jokes about the girl with the bat. He'd have cracked my skull regardless. It hadn't even been to trust a girl with a gun. I had blindly gone after the first bad guy on my hit list when I should have been aiming further up the ladder, at the head of the Punchinello family. I couldn't bring myself to be pissed at Mona. Guess I had a soft spot for a few days. But when somebody decides to play baseball with your head, you tend to get sore.
We'll be right back.
The men in blue had come and gone. They had decorated the place with chalk outlines and tied it together with yellow tape. The cops who had stayed behind were dead. Frankie, his boys, and I had the place all for ourselves. Hotel bar was fast developing quite a history. True to his words, Frankie was there, having a beer.
Jesus Christ. How the hell did you get loose?
Got bored waiting. Thought, what the hell, we could just as well finish this here. Smoke signals. The Mercedes was revving to go, almost drowning out the Banshee well of the sirens.
You coming? We'll drop you off at the Punchinello Manor.
Sounds good to me.
When this is over, look me up. I could use a professional like you.
I'll keep that in mind. The night groaned with cold. The garden lights flickered nervously. In their light, the falling snow was dead white before the darkness ate it up. I had heard the stories. The trio were mad dogs. They'd have hung the heads of their enemies over the manor gates if the capo had only let them. Punchinello wanted pain. He'd see the pain. Someone had graciously left the back door open for me and killed the guards. My money was on Mona. I knew the trio would be standing between me and Punchinello. I had read their rap sheets, thick as phone books. No one would be walking out of here alive. The word on Lisa Punchinello is that she was a bit of a witch. The tarot cards on the kitchen table fit the picture. They weren't my kind of cards, but I was willing to take a crack at the hand Mrs. Punchinello had dealt. The first card was the tower. Maybe that was supposed to be the manor. It got easy after that. The devil was the master of the house, and death was me coming for him. Punchinello on the phone begging for help. He should have been saying his goodbyes. Ah. I could tell when I was outgunned. It was time to take another beating. The mystery witch was a real barracuda. Trouble at dagger heels, a smoking assault rifle in her hand, and an army of killer suits behind her.
How sweet. I get to kill two birds with one stone.
Sooner or later, it was going to catch up with you.
Mr. Payne, it's time to show you the benefits of my brew. Be a good boy now.
You'd find that Lady Luck was really a hooker. You were fresh out of cash.
Gentlemen, we're done here. Take me to Cold Steel.
You're just giving me an OD of Valkyr. I could feel green fire eating my brains. They turned to steam. They did a fade on me. I'd never had a chance. The witch had got me just as sure as if she put a gun to my head and pulled the trigger. The shadows rushed me. Bruised mugshot faces hungry for revenge. They knew my weak spots and closed in for the kill. The floor turned into a vortex of green blood. I fell.
Max, something happened at the office today. A strange memo. Something about Vikings.
Honey, I gotta run. You can tell me all about it this evening.
Have a nice day, darling.
The bullet holes were rubies on her chest, blood crawling on her ivory skin. She was so beautiful. The killer was smiling. The flesh of fallen angels. Slowly, the green nightmare faded, leaving dark stains on my soul that would never come off. I felt like flatlining. I was all shook up. I woke up in a cold sweat, sick and tired to the bone, lying upon the land puke. The hag had said take me to Cold Steel before it had all gone crazy. It was a clue. The only one I had. It took me forever to crawl back to my feet and hit the road. But when I did, I drove straight to Cold Steel Foundry outside the city. There was a whole lot of action around the place for a freezing winter night. Trucks coming and going, men running. I had the drop on the mystery witch. She thought I was dead. I was on her blind side. I was going in.
Thank you.
Mercenaries were running a tight operation, paperwork and all.
Merchandise missing again. A chemist had tried to smuggle it out for his own private party. Locked him up in cell B7 and D6's old test facility to wait for proper processing.
I was close enough to hear the secrets, just beyond the next doorway.
Thank you.
There was an old army bunker under the steel mill. I knew the military plaque on the floor. I had seen a thousand variations of the insignia on crumbling brick walls everywhere in the city. The sword replaced by a syringe. Project Valhalla. V for Valkyr. V for Valhalla. All of a sudden it read like a crackpot conspiracy theory.
Thank you.
piece together a jigsaw, and the final picture is you finishing that same puzzle. A mad, green-eyed killer standing behind you. An urban legend come true. The Project Valhalla test subjects had been the mad junkies who had murdered my loved ones. The rest was simple body count math. It all pointed to her. Ms. Valkyr. The factory went up in a fiery inferno behind me. All my leads were dead, turned to smoke and dust. I'd lost my way. I hadn't slept in a million years. Woden was waiting for me on the steps of the old building.
Mr. Payne, let's go inside. The others are anxious to begin.
The others?
Despite the general misconception, this building actually predates the City Hall by 2 years. Must be the oldest municipal building still in use here at the foot of the Brooklyn Bridge.
No kidding. The old man played tour guide as he led me through a dark domed hall. The answers I was after loomed large ahead.
Mr. Payne, I would like to introduce you to my colleagues in what we call the Inner Circle.
You've been watching too much X-Files.
You have seen the files on Project Valhalla. We can fill the gaps, provide you with the information missing from those files. We were all involved in the early stages of the project during the Gulf War.
What's the catch?
We would very much like to blow this thing wide open, but our hands are tied. Her name is Nicole Horn. She was the key figure in Project Valhalla. When the funding was discontinued, she simply refused to quit. She knew exactly what she had in her hands. Nicole Horn is the president of Acer Corporation. She has more than half the city in her pocket. This must be kept under wraps. If you try to go public with this, we will deny any knowledge. We need you to take her out. Afterwards, we can protect you. Make all the charges go away.
That was the cue for the killer suits to kick in the doors and swarm inside. It was an impressive floor show, but I decided to leave early anyway. It was only a one-story fall. Lucky me.
Oh.
I took my time, cruising around the city in the snow. There was no hurry. I knew what I had to do now. I took my time, thinking about it, building up the rage. When I was ready, I parked the stolen wheels at the front entrance of the Acer Corporation headquarters. Got out, got in, got cracking. I had a bullet with Nicole Horn's name on it. I had 10,000 bullets with the hag's name on them. She had ultra-high-tech security systems, enough mercenaries and weaponry to start World War III. There was no fear. New York disappeared behind a veil of snow. I had crossed the threshold. This was her domain, sleek and sexy and soulless, all glass and steel. A place of color-coded security key cards, metal detectors, and surveillance systems. Colder than a walk-in fridge. Cold as a gun.
Max, we gotta stop meeting like this.
It will be a cold day in hell before I let a Nard cop stop me. Miss Sachs, do your job.
Relax, Max. You're a nice guy. I don't kill nice guys.
You're not bad yourself.
It was different when Horn wanted Punchinello dead, to cut her ties to the Mafia. He deserved to die.
The same goes with her. She's the bad guy here. Her sister was whispering to her in my favor. I knew the appetites of ghosts intimately. They hungered for revenge.
No!
A gunshot boomed and she fell down in slow motion. She was a nice girl, not really a stone-cold killer. And now she was stone-cold dead. If religious fanatics or loyal samurai, Horn's private army was coming at me. When the elevator came back down, Mona was gone. There was a lot of blood, but no body. Something clicked for the final time. My mind had never been so clear, as if somewhere high above the storm clouds were already gone, cold stars blazing from the black skies. next to the printer was a neat stack of expensive paper. Hacking through Horn's computer would have unearthed files of criminal plans, strategies for world domination, spy helicopter reports, illegal wiretap recordings, internet porno, all of the above. Take your pick. I really didn't care anymore. I had seen too much of it already. Valkyr had been meant to be a white-winged maiden that would lift you to a warrior's heaven, but it turned out to be a one-way demon ride to hell. The devil was in the drug. I knew. I had met him. And now I was gonna kill her. The queen of the underworld who had tried to lift herself a bit closer to heaven with her drug money. No begging, no bribes. She knew better. Honor among killers. We who were about to die, both of us knew how this would end, in pain and suffering.
All this because your wife stuck her nose into things that were none of her business.
The cops were coming to take me away. The sirens were like a bad conscience I couldn't shake.
It's ridiculous you've made it this far. You won't be alive when they get here.
Seemed to lose its frenzy. The ragged clouds gave way to the stars above.
Max Payne, this is Deputy Chief Jim Gravora from the NYPD. We've got the building surrounded. Throw down your weapons and lie down with your hands behind your head.
A bit closer to heaven. The cops' voices were distant and muted. Ghosts released me from their haunting. Down below, New York City glittered like diamonds on black velvet.
You gave us one hell of a ride. Take him down to Central Booking.
You heard the man.
Logan was there in the crowd, standing by the sidelines. It wouldn't be over till the man with the patch would say so. He'd say the right words. I knew he would. He'd better. Woden grinned smugly. It was the grin of a winner. That made two of us,